Hello everyone, my name is Vinh Trương Hoàng, I'm from Ho Chi Minh City Open University. So today we present my paper entitled Face Recognition Based on Selection Approach via Canonical Correlation Analysis Feature Fusion. This is the outline of my presentation. First, I will present the introduction of a problem. Secondly, I will present Hopf and Zipf descriptor. Thirdly, I will present feature selection and canonical correlation analysis. Next, I will present experimental results, and finally, we present the perspective and conclusion of this work. Face analysis is a highly active research topic in artificial intelligence with a wide application including video surveillance, personal identification, digital entertainment, or e-commerce. It is a classical topic and is still very active in machine vision and image understanding. Face matching consists of two different tasks, such as face verification and face recognition. The first one is used to determine whether a given pair of facial images represent the same person, while the latter is applied for recognizing the same person from a setup gallery. Many approaches have been proposed during the past half century for an efficient recognition, which can be grouped into two categories, the conventional feature extraction method and the deep learning approach. In this work, we first apply feature fusion extracted from Hopf and Zipf descriptor from facial image and use canonical correlation analysis, in short CCA, to combine into a single feature. The Hopf descriptor is firstly applied for object detection area and have various applications in pattern recognition, which capture feature by counting the occurrence of radiant magnitude and orientation of the local image. Traditionally, Hopf divide the image into different cells and calculate a histogram of radiant orientation over them. The computation of Hopf feature involves three steps. The first step is compute the radiant magnitude of the input image both in the horizontal and vertical direction. Secondly, it builds histogram of orientation for each cell by accumulating the magnitude of a radiant into bin for each orientation. Finally, it normalizes the histogram within each block of cell, then constructs the image feature by combining on histogram into a single vector. The Zipf descriptor Eman image operator proposed by Olivia and Toraba for scene recognition. It is based on a low dimensional characterization. The feature represented by dominant spatial structure is a set of statistical properties, naturalness, openness, roundness, expansion, richness. Moreover, this summarized the radiant information for scale and orientation for different parts of an image. This approach presents a root description of an image. The right scale input image is normalized by the intensity and locally scaling the construct and displayed into a root on several scales. Canonical correlation, in short CCA, is a learning scheme for calculating the linear relationship between two multidimensional variables, which shift the projection by maximizing the correlation between two type pictures. The feature method. First, a feature score is a feature selection approach used for ranking feature based on evaluation strategy. This method can be considered as a pre-processing step without involving the classifier to select a subset of relevant feature. The main idea of feature score is to identify a subset of feature so that the distance between samples in different classes are as large as possible, while the distance between samples in the same class are as small as possible. The robust approach is evaluated on three common facial databases, IR, JOSTAT, and MUCT. The original image of this database have different resolution. We first manually perform a facial alignment and resize all image into 128 times 128 for IR and GT dataset are 256 and 256 visual for MUCT dataset. Several samples are present in the first figure. In our experiment, we employ one NN classifier to recognize facial image of the testing set, and the classification performance is evaluated by the accuracy rate. The training and the testing image are summarized in the table for each dataset. The first table presents the number of features extracted from different strategies. The Hop and Gist feature is the simple concatenation of Hop and Gist feature, while the Hop and Gist and CCI is the feature obtained by CCI approach on Hop and Gist feature. We see that CCI reduces a large number of features with more than 90%. The second table shows the classification result of Hop Gist and Hop and Gist and Hop and Gist CCI feature. For IR dataset, Hop and Gist and Hop and Gist and CCI feature give same accuracy at 90.15%, while this descriptor outperforms all the features on GT and MUCT dataset. The last table presents the performance of feature selection approach by on CCI feature. The Hop and Gist and CCI and feature selection outperform other methods on three datasets and significantly reduce number of features. Comparing with the result in the second table, the feature selection method gave nearly 96% on IR dataset, while it only used 1,241 features. Similarly, we can find the same conclusion. This approach allows to reduce a large number of features on GT and MUCT dataset. We presented a method to improve the performance of face recognition by applying the feature selection on the CCI feature. The experiment is evaluated on three facial databases, which has shown the efficiency of the proposed approach by improving the accuracy rate and reduce a large number of dimensions. The future of this work is now extended to combine facial selection scheme to compare the performance. We would like to answer the two questions raised from the committee. The first question, does the facial recognition method depend on the input image taken and how? Can you list some real-world use case in which your method would perform optimally? We'd like to answer this question. In our experiment, we evaluated our proposed approach on three benchmark datasets. On image from the dataset acquired from various condition, and the experimental results show the efficiency of our approach. So we think there's no constraint required to take image. The potential application of our approach can be applied for face recognition or face matching. For the second question, can you comment on how a requirement need to run your solution in real time? So we didn't try to apply this approach for real time problem. So this may be an extension for our work in the future. Thank you.